Hi everybody. So I am just back from the theaters. I saw the new director's cut of Rocky IV. Sylvester Stallone recut Rocky IV and released it to theaters one night only, which was tonight. And I believe tomorrow it will be available on most streaming services. Film is retitled Rocky IV, Rocky vs. Drago. And given that Rocky IV is one of my absolute favorite movies, I had to see it in theaters tonight. And I was really curious to see what Stallone wanted to do with this. So I guess this project was born out of Stallone sort of being out of work and having nothing to do during the COVID lockdowns of 2020. Much like every artist, he was just kind of stuck at home, twiddling his thumbs. He had a movie he was working on, but that got shut down for a year. So he decided the best way to keep himself creative was to recut one of his most iconic movies. When I saw that announcement on social media earlier this year, I was very interested. But I was a little apprehensive, because one of the reasons that Rocky IV is one of my favorite movies is that, at least in my opinion, it is an absolute masterclass in editing. I think one of the film's best strengths is the cut. It is the editing. It's a very tightly cut, lean movie that goes by real quick, and it's just nothing but the good stuff. And I guess that's what kind of bothered Stallone. Before the film, they cut to a live stream Stallone was doing in Philadelphia, and it was an interview in which he talked about the Rocky series as a whole and, you know, why he decided to do this project. And his issues with the original cut of Rocky IV was that it was too of its time. Very MTV with montages. And he said that he cut a lot of the more human elements of the story out because he felt that might be wasting the audience's time and that's not what fans wanted to see. And I gotta say, I was a little taken aback by that. I sort of agree that if Rocky IV lacks anything, there could be some more human moments. There could be some scenes that would be reinserted. So I was fine with that end of it. But when he started talking about the montages in a way that was not positive or sort of embarrassed by it, I got very nervous. Because when he announced that he was going to be recutting Rocky IV, the first thing he said was, "And the movie's not going to have that damn robot."
Happy birthday, Molly.
I don't know if he realizes, but, like, the robot is not an unwelcome part of the movie. It's funny. It's very weird. And it definitely dates the movie. Right away, it makes it a very 80s movie. But it doesn't take away from the story. It just adds a little bit of comedy. But, you know, maybe he thinks it sticks out like a sore thumb, so he wanted that to go. So I'm not too distraught about that. But when he started talking about the montages of the movie, describing it as very MTV, I got really nervous because I thought, oh, God, I hope he didn't cut any of those out. If even one of those montages is missing from the film, that's like a full letter grade down as far as I'm concerned. Since the damn Star Wars movies, a director's cut or a reimagining or a new cut is not always like, oh, this must be better sort of thing. Don't get me wrong. I think very highly of Stallone. But we've seen better directors than him go back to their old work, putz around with it, and the end result is not ultimately positive. I mean, Spielberg has even got into doing that kind of stuff, and the little tweaks he's made in certain movies, not really positives. So, I went into this movie both excited, yet also a little nervous. But, now that I've seen it, I can confidently say that the movie is not ruined. I don't know if I'm going to say it was improved. In fact, I don't think it was actually improved. I don't think it's better than the original cut of Rocky IV. But I think it is very interesting, and I think that there are definitely some scenes that Stallone added back in that are very welcome. There are changes that he made that are actually pretty impressive. The biggest positive of the movie is seeing these deleted scenes.
He's had one professional fight and one man is dead. But if it prevents another fatality, it's well worth it.
These are clips that have never been seen before. Many of them really do add to the story. They are human moments. So if you love the Rocky series for the characters and the acting performances, we see more of Carl Weathers. We see more of Talia Shire. And it's great. So if just for that alone, it was a good experience. It was fun to see the film with some additional deleted scenes in. But that is not at all the extent of this movie. This is not a director's cut with the deleted scenes added in. This film is truly re-edited, down to very small edits. In fact, I would say a lot of the edit are tiny little changes that most viewers wouldn't even notice unless you're like a nerd like me who's seen the original version of Rocky IV like 100 times. And some of those little changes were good, but I can't say all of them were. In fact, there were a couple of moments that stuck out to me as, I think, the wrong decision. There were a few things that he cut out seemingly for no reason. It's hard to describe without talking about the scenes themselves, so I'll just take you through a few. In the fight between Drago and Apollo Creed in Vegas, they're standing face to face. In the original cut of the movie, Apollo says,
"Come on, get your hands up, man! You need an interpreter? It's time to go to school!"
And that's when Apollo realizes he might be in over his head. Sly changed it a little bit. In this, Apollo says, "Get your hands up," but then Drago smashes Apollo's hands down, which is a very unnecessary change. And I think it's not a good change because Drago does the exact thing to Rocky in the final fight in Russia. And I don't want to waste too much time talking about why I think little stuff like that was the wrong decisions. I'll just point a couple of things out for you to look for when you see the movie, and then you can make up your own mind if you think it's the right call or not. In the same fight scene in Vegas, right before Apollo dies, you know, he tells Rocky, "Don't stop the fight." And there's a moment in the original version where he turns to his wife and motions to her with his glove to say that he's okay. In this version, they show him look to his wife, but he doesn't raise his fist to say he's okay. That's an important little moment there. Another real little change, and I mean real little, is when they're in Russia and Duke is playing chess with their Russian chaperone and he beats him in chess. In the original cut, the Russian knocks over all the chess pieces. And it's a small moment, but it's kind of funny. In this scene, he says checkmate and then it cuts right away. Except when he says checkmate, you actually see his hand go to knock over the chess pieces, but it cuts too fast. So you don't actually see him do it. Again, a change that just made me think, like, why? What was the why didn't Stallone like that? That didn't seem like an embarrassing moment or something that didn't need to be there. It's a little funny. So, again, can you tell I've seen the original cut of Rocky IV way too many times? I know these are just, again, micro moments of the film, but I think they're important. I don't think the film is served by cutting them out. Maybe this was Stallone being a little stir-crazy. Now, I talked a lot about characters who get more screen time, particularly Adrian and Apollo. Another character that gets more screen time is Drago's evil Russian manager, the old guy. He definitely gets more lines, he gets more screen time now, but that comes at the expense of Brigitte Nielsen. And I'm sure I'm not the only one who noticed this, but Brigitte Nielsen's character is reduced to almost nothing. Almost all of her lines are cut. She's still present in the film, and her close-ups are often kept. But her lines, almost all of her lines are gone. The only time she really talks is in that news conference that plays on Apollo's TV when he's playing in the pool with his dogs. I found that to be very interesting. Now, I don't want to be catty, but I just wonder, given that Brigitte is Sly's ex-wife, was he just a little too heavy with the scissors on her scenes as almost sort of a dick?
He's a horrible husband. At least he was with me.
Again, I love Stallone, but I really don't think he, and frankly, a lot of Hollywood celebrities are above doing something like that. So that's probably my strongest criticism of this director's cut. Not enough Brigitte Nielsen. And that probably says it all. It's not the biggest deal. All of the foundational pieces of the film are intact. All of the montages are there. The fight scenes are still very good. Apollo's death scene is still incredibly emotional. The James Brown scene is still spectacular. All of the stuff that made Rocky IV truly iconic are undisturbed, and there are little tweaks that Sly made that are fun to see. There's additional scenes of the film that definitely contribute more to the story and flesh out the film a little more than its original version, so I appreciate that. There's just a couple of little changes that I'm not on board with, and again, I think Stallone was a little too heavy with the scissors on Brigitte Nielsen. Oh, one thing I should notice that I actually liked a lot was the film has a new opening. They took a lot more from Rocky III for the opening of this movie. So it's much more of a Rocky III recap in this one than the original cut, and I actually think that's a positive. And also, if I'm being honest, it's really nice to hear Sweetest Victory playing in that opening. That's a really nice song, and hearing that even for just a few seconds at the end of the opening was actually pretty cool. And I think that's about it. If you're a diehard fan of Rocky IV, like I am, of course you should see Stallone's director's cut. It adds more to the story, fleshes out the characters just a little bit more, and even though it sounds like I'm complaining about a couple of the changes, they're fairly harmless changes. So it might be fun to watch it and just see if you notice those things or notice the changes that I didn't mention. And of course, the original is absolutely in no danger of being replaced with this one. This film is truly supplemental material. So I guess I would just recommend seeing Rocky IV Director's Cut if you're a fan of Rocky IV. And if you haven't seen Rocky IV, my goodness, do yourself a favor. See the original cut of the movie. It is a brilliant piece of entertainment from the 80s. And I don't think that's a bad thing. I guess maybe that would be my own criticism of Stallone, and it's just what I took away from this sort of press event he did as part of the live stream before the movie. Like, being dated, a film being dated, is not necessarily a negative. So he shouldn't be ashamed for what Rocky IV was. And thankfully, he didn't bend over backwards to try and hide it. So with that, I'll just say it's streaming now. Go check it out. Tell me what you think. Tell me what changes you noticed, which ones you liked, which ones you didn't. Post that all in the comments below. And of course, please like and subscribe. Find us on Facebook and Twitter for more content, mostly about classic rock, but occasionally I will talk about movies as well. So thanks again for tuning in. Take care.